From Pacifica, this is Democracy Now!
By standing up to the special interests who prevented reform for decades and who are furiously lobbying against it now, the Senate has moved us closer to reform that makes a tremendous difference for families, for seniors, for businesses, and for the country as a whole.
President Obama hails lawmakers for standing up to special interests and health care reform. But a new study tells a very different story. At least 166 former congressional aides involved in shaping health care legislation have registered to lobby for health care companies, among them 14 former aides to House Majority Leader Steny Hoyer and at least 13 to Senate Finance Chair Max Baucus, the key overseer of health care reform. Then, in the face of mounting criticism, UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon defends the outcome of the Copenhagen Climate Summit.
I'm aware that the outcome of the Copenhagen Conference, including the Copenhagen Accord, did not go as far as many would have hoped. Nonetheless, they represent a beginning, an essential beginning. We have taken an important step in the right direction.
We'll speak with the nation's leading climate scientist, James Hansen. He wasn't in Copenhagen. He said it would be better for the planet if the talks ended in collapse. We'll ask him why. Dr. Hansen will join us to talk about the summit and his new book, Storms of My Grandchildren, The Truth of the Coming Climate Catastrophe and Our Last Chance to Save Humanity. All that and more coming up. Welcome to Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. I'm Amy Goodman. The Senate's prepared to take two more key procedural votes today on overhauling the nation's health care system. A final vote on the legislation is expected on Christmas Eve. On Monday, the American Medical Association endorsed the legislation, and President Obama described the Senate's actions as historic. But many progressive supporters of Obama have decried the Senate legislation, in part because Democrats removed a proposal to create a government-run insurance program. Many questions still remain over how congressional leaders will merge the House and Senate bills. Wall Street has reacted favorably to the Senate bill. Stock prices of health insurance companies have been soaring since October 27th, when independent Senator Joe Lieberman announced he would filibuster any health care reform bill that included a public option. Since then, the stock value of Cigna has jumped 29%, Aetna 27%, United Health over 20%, and Humana almost 14%. During that same period, the Dow Jones Industrial Average has risen by just over 2%. Iranian President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad has defended Iran's decision to put three young American hikers on trial after they accidentally crossed the Iran-Iraq border. The American, Shane Bauer, Sarah Shourd, and Joshua Fatal have been detained since July. In September, Ahmadinejad said he would ask Iran's judiciary to look at the case with maximum leniency. But in a new interview with Diane Sawyer of ABC News, Ahmadinejad was less reassuring when Sawyer asked him if he's still going to do his best to set the hikers free.
Yes, but I've got a question to you. How do you know they have accidentally crossed into Iran? How do you know they were looking for waterfalls?
You have evidence that it was not accidental? Young people on a hike, on a vacation?
Who has told you this? Are you a judge? Permit me.
By all examination.
Have the intelligence agents told you that?
They will go on trial?
I'm not the judge to judge about it.
President Ahmadinejad speaking on ABC News. The Guardian newspaper reports U.S. special forces have conducted multiple clandestine raids into Pakistan as part of a secret war in Pakistan's tribal areas. A former NATO officer said the incursions occurred between 2003 and 2008 and involved helicopter-borne elite soldiers. The NATO officer said, quote, "The Pakistanis were kept entirely in the dark about it. It was one of those things we wouldn't confirm officially with them." Last month, independent journalist Jeremy Scahill revealed the private military firm Blackwater is also part of a covert program in Pakistan that includes planning the assassination and kidnapping of Taliban and al-Qaeda suspects. A Somali man just released from Guantanamo described his time at the U.S. military prison as, quote, hell on earth. Mohamed Salaban Bari was one of 12 Guantanamo prisoners released over the weekend. He told Agence France-Presse, quote, "Some of my colleagues in the prison lost their sight, some lost their limbs, and others ended up mentally disturbed. I'm okay compared to them," he said. Barry was first detained in Pakistan and then transferred to a series of U.S. military prisons. He said, quote, at Bagram and Kandahar, the situation was harsh, but when we were transferred to Guantanamo, the torture tactics changed. They use a kind of psychological torture that kills you mentally, he said. The words of Mohamed Salaban Barry. A group of 16 human rights and humanitarian organizations have accused the international community of betraying the people of Gaza by failing to end the Israeli blockade. The report argues Israel's blockade of Gaza is a form of collective punishment. Israeli authorities have allowed only 41 truckloads of construction materials into Gaza since the end of its three-week invasion last January. Thousands of such deliveries are needed to repair homes. The report was released to coincide with the first anniversary of the Israeli attack that killed more than 1,400 Palestinians. Meanwhile, Egypt has rejected a request to allow international activists to cross the border into Gaza later this week as part of the Gaza Freedom March. Over 1,300 activists from 42 countries are set to participate in the march. In a statement, organizers of the march said, quote, our efforts and plans will not be altered at this point. We have set out to break the siege of Gaza and march on December 31st against the Israeli blockade. We are continuing in the same direction, it said. In news from El Salvador, the website Upside Down World reports a prominent anti-mining activist has been assassinated. Ramiro Rivera Gomez was vice president of the Cabañas Environmental Committee and a leader in the resistance against gold mining projects proposed by the Vancouver-based Pacific Rim Mining Company. Another anti-mining activist, Marcelo Rivera, was murdered earlier this year in El Salvador. Brazilian President Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva has proposed forming an investigative body to examine crimes committed during the country's 1964-85 military rule. During the dictatorship, as many as 20,000 people were believed to have been tortured, often through the use of electric shocks and chemicals, and over 400 Brazilians were murdered or disappeared. Unlike neighboring countries such as Argentina and Chile, Brazil has never convicted anyone for participating in dictatorship-era abuses and has refused to make public the military's archives from the period. Lula's chief of staff, Dilma Rousseff, said the Truth Commission is needed for Brazil to move forward.
It's always painful to remember all those people that went to prison, all those who were brutally tortured in some way. Many times, those people who were left with no trace of humanity, and many times, their lives were taken.
Dilma Rousseff, chief of staff to Brazil's president. Rousseff is seen as a likely candidate in the October 2010 elections to succeed Lula. Meanwhile, in Guatemala, the government has agreed to pay $3 million to compensate victims of a 1982 massacre in the mountain hamlet of Dos Eres, where more than 200 villagers were killed by a special forces unit. The payment was announced following a ruling by the Inter-American Court of Human Rights. In other news from the region, Mexico City has become the first city in Latin America to legalize same-sex marriage. City lawmakers passed the measure by a 39-20 vote. The bill changes the definition of marriage from the union of a man and a woman to the free uniting of two people. The environmental group Greenpeace is calling on the Danish government to release four of its members who have been held in jail since Thursday. The activists were arrested after managing to enter the Danish royal palace in Copenhagen ahead of a dinner for the 120 heads of state participating in the climate talks. After tricking security guards, the activists arrived just before Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's envoy. They were arrested after holding up a banner that read, "Politicians talk, leaders act." Kumi Naidu, the head of Greenpeace International, said, quote, while the perpetrators of the real crime fled the country on private jets, it's shocking that the Danish authorities have decided to detain without trial four peaceful protesters over Christmas. The Washington Post reports states are quickly running out of funds to pay unemployment compensation funds due to the nation's high jobless rate. 25 states have already run out of unemployment money and have borrowed $24 billion from the federal government to cover the gaps. Another 15 states are expected to go broke within 2 years. The military